Good morning students. In the last class we are discussing a queues. Queue is a linear data structure. It is a linear data structure, follows first in first out principle. First in first out principle, it has two open ends, one for insertion, one for remove. One for insertion and one for remove. Insertion is at a rear pointer end, remove or deletion at front pointer end. If both the pointers are set to front and the rear, both the pointers are set to minus 1, then the queue is empty queue. This is very very important to remember. So empty queue, empty means underflow. Empty means underflow. If the rear pointer reaches to n minus 1, if the rear pointer, only rear pointer reaches to n minus 1, then the queue is full. Full means overflow. Full means overflow. Empty means underflow. Okay. So here insertion is takes place at a rear end, remove or deletion takes place at front end. Insertion is called NQ operation. Remove is called DQ operation. So each and every one is important. In the array, it was directly insertion and deletion. Insertion and deletion. In the stack, insertion is called push, deletion is called pop. In the queue, insertion is called NQ, deletion is called DQ. Okay, so if the question comes, write an algorithm for insertion with array, then this algorithm you should write. Insertion with the stack, instead of asking a direct question with a push, insertion with the stack, then the push algorithm. So insertion with the queue, insert an element into queue. It is not an insertion array. Please remember the question. Please read in which data structure you are performing insertion or deletion. Depending on that, you need to write. Insertion with a data structure called a stack, then you are doing push operation. Insertion with the queue data structure, then the operation name is NQ. Then array, direct question, that is a insertion. But identifying the data structure which it was given is very very important. Depending on that, your marks will be there. If you write whichever you know, you will not get the marks. Depending on the data structure, that algorithm you need to write. Here, queue, stack, everything is implemented with the array data structure. First, we are discussing with the array data structure. Once the concept of the linked list was completed, then once we will write the implementation of stack, queue also in the linked list representation. Till that, it is a array data structure. So I have taken the queue name called queue 0. This is queue of 0, queue of 1, queue of 2, queue of 3. Then what is the size of queue? Size is 4. If that reaches to the n minus 1, 4 minus 1 called 3, then queue is full. Okay, so insertion also an array gets incremented by 1. Deletion also your queue gets, that is a front pointer gets incremented by 1. There is no concept of decrementation in the queue concept. Only decrementation in the array concept and stack concept. But here incrementation both. After insertion, rear pointer get incremented by 1. After deletion, also front pointer get incremented by 1. These are the minimum concepts you need to remember for the queue. Okay. These are the things we discussed in the last class along with the operation. Four operations we discussed now. Once again, that is NQ, DQ and is empty and is full. So other than that, size. Whatever, wherever the rear pointer is there, that is the number of elements present in the queue that gives you size of the queue. Traversal begins always with the front pointer till the rear pointer. Front pointer till the rear pointer. Before that, we move for the types of the queue. Today's class we discuss one of the 3 marks question, that is types of Q. Q, always write the complete sentence Q U E U E. Don't write only Q. If you are writing the declaration of the Q, then you can write the Q. So don't write only Q as a short form to write the Q name, and don't write this is also Q, this is also Q, this is also Q. Technically, this is the word is a correct word. You whenever you are writing, write the complete word N Q E N. There also Q U E U E is compulsory. D Q D E Q U E U E. Okay, the spelling is very very important. Sometimes those who are getting 69 and 70 in the third valuation, you are going to lose the marks for these technical words. Those who are trying for 70, please remember all the technical words. Technical words only gives you complete marks. So first we discuss the Q. Whatever we discussed now, Q, that is called simple Q. Simple Q. That means there is a one Q structure. There is a one Q structure. Q of 0, Q of 1, Q of 2, Q of 3. If the elements are there, then this is called a front pointer and this is called rear pointer. This is your simple Q. That means we created an empty Q and we are doing some operation, insertion at the rear pointer end, insertion at rear pointer end and deletion at front pointer end. What we discussed till now, the data structure is called simple Q data structure. Did you got it? Here we have one data structure that is implemented either with the array or linked list, doesn't matter. It is going to support you to perform the operation called insertion at the rear end, deletion at front end is called simple Q. Then the next one, circular Q. Circular Q. Actually, this is compulsory, need to be implemented with the linked list data structure. There is a one data structure. There are elements. This is Q of 0, Q of 1, Q of 2, Q of 3, 30, 40. Generally, till we have not deleted any item, that is the element present in the data structure. So this is called front at deletion. Okay. So generally, here is a rear pointer for insertion. And that rear pointer, what we have, the rear which is going to be identify the index, that index is connected to the front. Then front pointer will gives you in the circular Q rear position also. Your front pointer gives rear position also because it is being connected in the circular fashion. Front contains rear index also. Rear index also. Hence it is called circular Q. That means generally we implement this one in the linked list data structure. The last node of the Q connected to the first node of the Q. First node of the Q in a circular fashion. That is called circular Q. Circular Q. Then the third one called priority Q. Priority Q. Here one preset priority. Preset priority will be present. 1, 2, 3. This is called priority. So here one data structure is there. Here one data structure is there. Here one data structure is there. This is for insertion. This is for deletion. So where you can see this priority Q? In the best example in the Tirupati temple. VIP Q. Then 300 rupees ticket. And this is a general. Those who are going with a general Q. Those who are having a VIP ticket, they will be exiting first because of the priority preset. For this queue, they have been preselected. So this queue is inserted only VIP persons. This queue is inserting only the elements of VIP. When this gate was opened, only priority queue of the one of the VIP persons are going to be exit. Then the related to the priority two. This is for your 300 rupees ticket. So those the people present in the queue of 300 rupees, the priority set will be assigned for them. It is the two. Removal of the element in the queue is done based on the priority. Hence it is called priority queue. Priority queue. Then the fourth one called double-ended queue. Double-ended queue. So this also implemented using a linked list. These two can implement either in the arrays or in the linked list. But these two, which is circular queue and doubly linked, double-ended queue, doubly linked list. It is being implemented with a doubly linked list. It is being implemented with a circular linked list. This is implemented with the linked list. Here, there is a queue. There is a queue. This is called one open end. This is called one open end. Generally, we know that this is for deletion. This is for insertion. In the double-ended queue, both insertion and deletion is possible in both the ends. Is possible in both the ends. Such a data structures are called double-ended queue data structure. This double-ended queue data structure is implemented using doubly linked list called linked list. Okay. This is about your types of queue. So once they ask the question in the supplementary, 5 marks also. A student, it is important for 5 marks along with the definition of queue. Definition of queue. Along with the definition. Definition 1 mark, each type along with the diagram is 1 mark. One line sentence is enough. You no need to do the complete representation, just the diagram gives you complete explanation. It is a simple queue implemented using either an array or linked list. Here, insertion is done at one end called array, deletion is done at another end called front pointer end. It is implemented with a simple data structure, hence it is called simple queue. Then, circular queue. Circular linked list, the rear pointer is connected to the front pointer end. So the front pointer gives you the index of the rear pointer. Hence it is called circular queue. It is being designed with the circular linked list. Circular linked list, this is a diagram represents your circular linked list. Then come to the priority queue. In the priority queue, there is a preset priority of the queue will be present in front of the queue. Before exiting the element, it is going to check the priority list. Depending on the priority, it is going to be exit. That is, elimination of the element is done based on the preset priority. Preset priority, that is called priority queue. Then come to the double-ended. Generally, it is opposite to your simple queue. In the simple queue, insertion is done at one end, deletion is done at another end. Opposite ends, we are going to perform the operation. But in the double-ended queue, both insertion and deletion is possible to perform in one end. So, insertion is also possible and deletion is also possible. And this double-ended queue is implemented with the doubly linked list. Doubly linked list. This is about your queues, types of queues. Then we discuss now NQ algorithm. Yes, we'll discuss now the algorithm called NQ. Inserting an element into the queue data structure is called NQ. Before going to the NQ algorithm, first we'll know the conditions which is required to write the NQ algorithm. Then we move for the writing the algorithm. So, NQ, first we need to check the condition called whether Q is empty or not. First we need to check the whether the Q is empty or not. Q is empty or not. How to check the Q is empty or not? When doing an insertion, we need to check for Q is full or not. When it is full, if the rate pointer reaches to the n minus 1, if the rate pointer reaches to the n minus 1, then just print the message called Q is overflow. Q is overflow. Okay. Then the next condition. Suppose Q was empty Q. There is no element present in that. There is no element present in that. That means both the pointers are set to minus 1, right? Front is minus 1 and your rear is minus 1. Rear is also minus 1. That means Q was created but there is no element. First we check that Q was full. If the Q size is 4, Q reaches to the n minus 1, that is called rear equal to n minus 1 called 3, then the Q is full. Insertion is not possible. Insertion is not possible. And the second condition we are testing, Q is there and whether that Q is empty Q. If both are empty, what's about the pointers? When both are empty, front and rear was set to minus 1. When both are set to minus 1, where to insert the element? Hence, set both the pointers to 0. Set both the pointers to 0. Did you understand the condition here? When both are minus 1, set front equal to 0 and rear equal to 0. Then only insertion is possible. Then only insertion is possible. Did you get? So, when both the pointers are set to minus 1, that is Q is empty. It was created, but there is no element present in that. That time, you need to initialize both the pointers to 0. When it is both the pointers are 0, then only insertion is possible. Suppose, if this is not a condition, already elements are there. Two elements are there. Front is here, rear is here. Where I should insert? Rear already contains the element. I should increment the rear, right? Then only possible to insert the element. Suppose if this is not a condition, then I should increment the rear pointer by 1. Are you getting? So, first I tested when there is no any element, that time both are set to minus 1. Front and rear both are set to minus 1. That time I initialize both the pointers to 0. Which one? Front to 0 and rear to 0. Both are pointing to Q of 0. Q of 0. Then with the place of rear it is possible to insert. But already few elements are there. Front is under 0. Rear is under 1. Then I should insert the next element. How I should insert? First increment the rear pointer by 1. Then insert the new element. That is called X part. Whatever the condition, I should insert the element, right? Where I should insert? I should insert the element at Q of rear. Which element? A new element what you need to insert. This will end here. Did you got it? If this is a condition, we are not performing NQ operation. If this is true, we are setting up rear and a front pointer to Q of 0. And this position we are inserting a new element. Suppose this is a condition is false, then control will come here. Already the element is there. Then increment the rear pointer by 1 and insert the new element. Did you understood how to write the NQ algorithm? Then it's time to write the algorithm for NQ. Step number one, start. It may or may not be, but we need to check the condition. Which condition you need to check? If rare is equal to the n minus 1, called a size minus 1. If this is the condition, Q is full. What you need to print? Q is overflow. Q is overflow. Then if this is the condition, we no need to perform any operation. Exit. Then end of if. Otherwise, you need to check that whether it is the empty cube or it contains the elements. If it is an empty cube, then if front equal to minus 1 and either you can use this and or 2 and any of that you can use, and rare equal to minus 1. If both are set to minus 1, then please initialize both to 0. Both to 0. Now, it is not an empty cube. A cube contains some of the elements. Then condition is false. Control move to the else part. Increment the rare pointer by 1. Rare pointer by 1. So, once the increment was done, then in the next step, insert the element. So, insert the element into the cube at rare pointer. At rare pointer. What you are inserting? You are inserting a new element. Then, step number 4, stop or return. So, this is your algorithm. So, first it is going to check whether the stack Q is full or not. So, Q size is 4, 10, 20, 30, 40. So, front was here, rare was here. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. So, already Q reaches to the n minus 1. So, rare reaches to the n minus 1. It will display the message. It will stop the procedure. Okay, are you getting it? Then, Q contains some elements. You contain some element. Your rare is at position 1. Then, front equal to minus 1. Is it a minus 1? No, it is 0. Front is 0. Then condition is false. Is rare equal to minus 1? No, condition is false. Rare is 1. Both are false. True, false, false and false. Condition is false. Control move to the else part. What is the rare? Rare is 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 1, 2. Then control comes to the end and Q of 2. Q of 2. Insert the new element. Insert the new element. Your rare pointer is here. Insert the element 30. Did you understood? Understood? Suppose if the Q was empty cube, both front equal to minus 1, rare equal to minus 1. Is it a rare n minus 1? Is it a n minus 1 or minus 1? It is minus 1 equal to the n minus 1. Condition is false. Control move to the if. Here, front is minus 1, S minus 1 is equal to the minus 1. And, that is your logical and. Condition is true here. Then, what is the rare? Rare is also minus 1. And, the value of the rare here in the cube, it is a minus 1. Is it a equal to minus 1? Yes, both are true. Both are true. What you should do? Set the pointer front to 0. And rare to 0. Did you got it? Then, what will happen? Insert the element 20. Insert the element 20. Q of rare. What is the rare now? 0. In the Q of 0, insert the element 20. 20 will be inserted. Again, it is going to check repeats. What is the rare here? 0. Is it a 0? N minus 1? Condition is false. Control comes here. Front is 0. It is minus 1. Here it is 0. Minus 1. Condition is false. Control come to the else part. It increment the rare by 1. Rare is 0. 0 plus 1? 1. Then control ends here. Come here. Q of 1. Q of 1. Insert the another element 30. So first rare L points here. Then it inserts the element 30 in the Q of 1. Did you understand? This is about your NQ algorithm. Okay. In the next class we discuss the DQ algorithm with the applications of Q. Okay, students, we meet in the next class with the DQ algorithm.